That sounds like something to put your baby to sleep. I didn't really want to do that. And of course, we've got pop-up headlights, and that just makes this car so... What's up, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this POV review by Autotop.nl. My name is Max, and today we are crossing one off the bucket list. We've been searching for one of these for ages. And well, we've finally been able to find one, and it is a really, really cool one at that. This is a supercharged Acura NSX from 1998, and today I'm going to review it. I'm going to show you around it, show you all the cool stuff on it. I hope I remember everything I read about this car, because there are so many cool things about this car. And the owner, Owen, has taken such good care of this car, has done a couple of really nice modifications. So that's what we're going to do today. I'm going to take it for a little drive after that, and we're going to take it to the Autobahn for a little Autobahn blast as well. But before we begin, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell if you want to receive updates when we upload a new video. And check us out on Instagram if you like, at Autotop.nl. You can also check out the owner of this car on Instagram, Supercharged NSX. I mean, go follow him, because this is such a cool car. Spoiler alert, I'm already freaking in love with this thing, and I've driven it for 10 minutes. Okay, so let's start with the Honda NSX, Acura NSX. We're just going to call it the NSX. Introduced in 1989, so long ago, and brought to market in 1990, I think. This was Honda's first try at a supercar, and it is a first for many things. For example, the first for an aluminium monocoque. This entire car basically has been made from aluminium to save weight. It weighs around 1350 kilos. If you have the Type R, that is 120 kilos lighter even. So that is the lightest version, 1230. But it was introduced when Honda was making, well, very mundane, sensible front-wheel drive hatchbacks. And they were doing all this cool stuff in Formula One. They powered the Williams Formula One car that took home two constructors' titles. And they thought, well, we have to do something with that. You know, we're not really taking advantage of that. So they wanted to make this supercar, but they did it the Honda way. So, of course, we've got VTEC. Of course, it is a very reliable car, and it was back then quite revolutionary for being so reliable that people were able to drive this every day, and it always worked. I mean, if you look at a Ferrari 328 or 348, the cars that this one had to compete with, I mean, they were so unreliable. And then this came around, and this car really forced other car manufacturers to think about their reliability and to do something about that. So it's a very important car. It's actually the first really daily drivable supercar, you know, the fuss-free one, the one you could just enjoy every day without worrying about it leaving you stranded on the side of the road. And of course, we've got pop-up headlights, and that just makes this car so 90s cool, right? So let's take a look around it. So it's a red one, and as you can see, it's a Targa. So earlier models had this black canopy. Like, this was all black, the roof was black, this was black, and that was to give it this idea of a fighter jet, because apparently they took some inspiration from the F-16 fighter jet. They wanted to create this like cockpit. You can see the wraparound windscreen. It's quite a tall windscreen. It runs down quite far, and that is to give you this cockpit idea. And that black roof really emphasized that. But this is a Targa, and that means that you just get the red roof. We're not going to take the roof out today, because on the Autobahn it's just not really great. This is one of the things that Owen changed. He installed these wheels, which are from a later NSX. So I think these were from 02 and after that, so 2002 and later. But this is a very nice wheel. That dark gray fits this car really well. And it's quite a long car, right? It's longer than I was expecting, but it's a really beautiful car. I think it's quite a timeless design. It works perfectly still. I still think this is a beautiful car. So at the rear, we've got quite a long rear with quite a bit of overhang there behind the rear wheels. And of course, we've got the engine in the middle right here. So this was the first time for Honda to do a mid-engined car and a rear-wheel drive car. They even took a Honda City, And they converted that from front engine front drive to mid-engine rear drive to see what would happen with the car, which is just awesome. So nice NSX logo with door opening right there. And the most friendly warning chime ever fitted on a car. I mean, that sounds like something to put your baby to sleep, not to warn you that your pop-up headlights are still up. Why did I open the trunk? I didn't really want to do that, but I'll show you guys. So we've got quite a bit big trunk. Fit two golf bags, of course, the age-old standard for boots. But I wanted to show you guys the engine, which is there. Does that open? Oh, that opens. Okay, so what we have here is a 3.2 liter V6 with dual overhead cams and VTEC variable valve timing. So the then boss at Honda instructed the engineer department to convert this 3 liter at the start, 1990, 3 liter V6 to fit the VTEC technology. Later in 1997, the 3 liter was replaced by the 3.2 liter. This is a 98 car, so this has that engine. The power output went from 280 horsepower and 294 newton meters of torque to 280 horsepower and 340 newton meters of torque. So it was really designed to increase the mid-range, to increase the torque, to make it a bit nicer to drive, you know, slowly. And that's also why they installed the VTEC on this engine, because it makes it possible to rev out to 8,000 RPM, have maximum power at 7,300 RPM, but still have some power at 2,000 RPM. That's really what VTEC does, basically, and it works really well. So Owen bought this car in the US with this Comptec supercharger and this Comptec exhaust. And this was apparently a dealer option, so you could have this supercharger installed at the dealer. And that's how Owen actually bought this car, at a dealer with this dealer installed supercharger. Really cool. It does run quite hot though, so he has this grated thing on top, which I think is from the Type R, to give it some more air to breathe. But man, look at that engine. It's so cool. All the Japanese stuff on here. So now with this supercharger, it's supposed to put out 370 wheel horsepower and around 400 newton meters of torque. So quite a healthy amount for a car that weighs 1350 kilos. With a manual gearbox, so we've got a 6-speed manual in here. The pre-97 cars had a 5-speed gearbox, and they also had the option to have an automatic gearbox, a 4-speed, which is horrible, I would say. And the automatic was actually the first car ever to feature electrically assisted power steering, but that was not available with the manual. This 98 does have power steering, and Owen also installed this brand new ABS unit here from a later, I think it's also from a 2002 NSX. This is also where your spare tire sits in here, but that tire was so old that Owen thought, well, I'm not going to use that anyway, so let's just remove that. But you can see how open and clear everything is. I mean, I can see the road down there. That's really awesome. Man, I am absolutely in love with this car. I've been dreaming about driving this car for quite some time, but it's very difficult to find one that you can drive hard, you know, because they're basically all like museum quality, if you can find one, in Europe at least. Owen told us that there are quite a few in the US that have done 250,000 miles, which is crazy. This has done 50,000. He also installed these later 2002 rear lights with these amber indicators, I think. But that looks really cool with those square rear lights. And of course, it's an Acura, which also is quite cool for us because we don't really see them that often here in Europe. Acura, of course, being the luxury brand from Honda, introduced in 1986. So in here, a beautiful interior, and you can see what they mean when they say they've been inspired by a fighter jet, by the F-16 canopy, because you have this wraparound windscreen that's quite long, quite tall, which works really well. It generates this air in here, which is very nice. Also, the fact that this dash is sloped like that, and it then transfers into the doors. You have this wraparound dash as well. It just works really well. Oh, it's quite hot. I'm going to open the door. But as you can see, this car looks freaking immaculate. The leather is so good still. And we've got these ruffles here in the leather. Totally 90s. We've got the serial number here. NSX, manufactured by Honda Motor Company. And this is number 238, I think. Yeah. But this just looks so cool. Beautiful seats, nice and supportive. I actually thought that I was not going to be able to fit in this car, but the seat goes back quite a bit. The steering wheel is positioned quite nicely, and I can fit actually pretty well in here. Beautiful gear lever. This is also from a later car, but this is absolutely gorgeous. And the shifts are just ridiculous. Now, also cool to show you guys, this is the original key. So that is absolutely beautiful. They really tried to make something special when they were making this car. And there are so many cool, fun facts about this car. I can't name them all. I mean, I even forgot about the jack that is in the rear, which is made from aluminium to save weight. I mean, how crazy is that? Okay, so let's start it up. I've got the key right here. Beautiful dials as well, just so simple, black and white. And in case you were doubting, we have a supercharger on there. Now that's a sound. Okay, let's take it for a drive.
What's up, bro?
What up? You know what it stands for, NSX. Nürburgring Sport Experience.
No, it actually is New Sports Car Experimental.
New Sports Car Experimental. That is awesome. The Japanese always know how to name things. Did you know that it used to have a hyphen between the N, the NS and the X, and they dropped that?
Why?
I don't know.
You know, it's based on a mid-engined hatchback.
No.
Made by the factory.
Yeah, I already saw that. Okay, let's take it for a drive. As I said, we've got this delicious 6-speed. It is one of the most satisfactory shifts I've enjoyed in my life. Honestly, it is ridiculous. Are we going right? No, we're going to hit the tunnel first. Let you guys enjoy that supercharger whine. Oh! The combination of that supercharger whine and that 3.2 liter V6 howling behind you is just so nice. It's one of the many benefits of driving a mid-engined car, is that you just have that thing behind you. You always feel that you've got it there and that it's making those beautiful sounds and pushing you forwards. Oh, the gearbox is just insane. It's also tilted a little bit. So if you go from third to fourth, you pull it towards you a little bit, which is so nice. RPM red line. Oh, this car, even though there are so many people that praise it so much, it's not overrated. It really delivers. The feel you have when you drive it, the light front, the light rear, the engine in the middle, the suspension, which is super compliant, and this even has a KW V3 suspension kit on it. But it's just such a friendly supercar. It's not an intimidating experience to drive it. And I think they just hit the nail on the head with this, because it was supposed to be like daily drivable. And even though it's freaking quick, of course, this is a supercharged version, so it's got almost 100 horsepower more than stock. It is, the power delivery is just so linear. Oh man. I get why Owen bought this car. Man, what, this is such a good car. I mean, this is from 1998. It just feels so good still. It ran from 1990 all the way to 2005, and they hardly changed anything on it. They did change the headlights in 2002. So that was the end of the pop-up headlights, unfortunately. But structurally, after that 3.2, they really didn't change anything. Oh man, I really want one of these. So here we are at the Autobahn. Now, it is quite hot today, and this car is not intercooled, so that Comtech supercharger really adds heat, and we have to be a bit careful, so we can't really stress it too much. I think 250 is the absolute max we're going to do today with this car, to not hurt it too much, but I mean, if we get the space, of course. This is second gear, 5,500 RPM. There's just something so satisfactory about driving this car. It just hits the spot. And this gear lever is positioned so well. Your arm is almost moving like only in one way, only laterally, which just feels so great. That was 240. You do feel that the brakes are a bit older, of course. Keep an eye on the temperature. For now, it's all good. All systems go. Some wind noise, of course, from the Targa roof. And that's 250. It is still a quick car. Of course, we have that supercharger, so it's a very nice amount of power, this. Very, very nice. So 100 to 200, we measured that at 10.54 seconds, which is very respectable. And Martijn also did a 0 to 100 in 5.4, but he said that it would be possible to do it in 5 seconds. So, yeah, we don't really want to extract 100% from this car, of course, because it is quite old and we don't want it to hurt. But it is an incredible car. It really lives up to the hype, and I think that this supercharger setup only makes it better. Because it really, it keeps that character of the V6, and it just adds that little bit of power to make it go, I mean, to modern standards fast, right? This is it's a fast car, but stock 280 horsepower. I don't think we would call that fast anymore. I would still love to drive a stock one, but this is, I think this supercharged version really means that it has a longer lifespan as a sports car, because it's still super enjoyable to drive and seriously quick. Oh, what a gearbox. I do think Owen had this steering wheel recovered with leather and added that red stitching, because that looks just new and it is very, very beautiful. So stock numbers, Martijn just looked it up for me, 5.7 to 100 and a top speed of 270 kilometers an hour. So I think this supercharged version, I mean, 5 seconds should be possible. Top speed, I don't know, 290, 300 probably. Now we're going to do this in first gear. Oh! What a car. Owen, man, I'm honestly a bit jealous. This is awesome. Thank you so much for taking it to us and letting us drive it. Oh, it is honestly one of the great car experiences of my life. This has been on our list for a long time, and it was a lot of fun. It really didn't disappoint. Thank you so much again, Owen. To you guys, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. You can subscribe by clicking the big button in the middle. You can also check out this video or go check out this playlist. See you at the next one. Bye, guys.